Sometimes I have to polish the surface with Scotch-Brite or sandpaper. Oops, maybe it's better to think at something safe first. This is my idea for a small but a simple stand. First, I think about the central support that it will be fit in the quick change tool post. I made a step for assembly and a counterbore hole for the M6 screw head after fixing in the vise of my milling machine. To measure the depth under the milling machine, I use my arrow hole gauge, really useful and small, a size that is impossible to obtain with a normal gauge, as it is under the head of the milling machine. The final dimension have to be very accurate, because in the final assembly, the two surfaces have to be in the same plane. And to be accurate, it's always good to use an edge finder. The counterbore holes have to be also very accurate, because not only the screw heads have to be inside, but also the hole have to be in the center to have a final good assembly. I use my little jack to support the piece without taking it out from the vise, and I drill a true hole to mount one of the casters. And I use my end mill to make a small counterbore on the hole to be sure that the future pin will be fixed in this hole. The thread pin was created from solid, starting from a 16mm diameter bar. I obtained the center diameter of 10mm and a thread of M6, always adding the trail leaf to go into the support. I created two short pins and one long pin. I'm sure that the head it will be of only 2mm of thickness, because it is used only to screw the pin to the support. It was not a long process or difficult, but every pin had to be accurate. Only in this manner you will find a good play between the wheels and the pin. And as for the shorter, also for the longer, the head was only of 2mm of thickness. For the wheels I use a Delrin bar. I have to color it purple, because the white doesn't show the edge, which are barely visible. The internal diameter of 35mm is important, because it is connected to the development of commercial sandpaper. The central hole is simple, because it's only from 10mm, done with a drill bit. I checked the sandpaper dimension with my small wheel, but also the depth of the hole, because the Delrin was to be enough for making two wheels, not only one. The challenge was to make two wheels that are free to move in the pins, but in the work will be stopped in the support device. I then built an aluminium wheel with a central knurling. It was the first time that I made something like this, but was the only idea to move the sandpaper by hand. My knurling tool is useful and work well, but have some place, and so it was not so easy to stay in the center of the pulley. But at the end, the pulley turning out very well. For the vertical wheel support, I use a square bar, but with a side of 12mm instead of 14mm. I created a central joint and M6 threaded holes to mount the sandpaper guide wheels. I added some counterbore holes, because in this way the pins rest and the wheels will be freedom to rotate but remain in the position. The effort that this support will have to support is low, because I take advantage of the elasticity of the sandpaper tape. I test the pin in the counterbore and in the M6 screw all, and I was very happy because it was really perfect, not only for the dimension but also for the plane on the wheel, because I test also the three wheels with the pin on the support, and it is perfect too because the wheel was free of movement. And after this test, it was arrived the moment to flatten the head of the pins. And for make this, I use my ER support, and I take two cuts of 1 mm side by side to have the possibility to use a range of 14 mm. Yeah, really 14, because it's a metric range. I tried to test everything, and also the range, and also the range was perfect. Only one screw was missing, and in this case that screw have two M6 side by side, and I decided to cut the diameter in the same moment to be sure that the two M6 was in the same axis. And making the M6 screw was very easy using my device. The only idea that I have to knurling this small disc was to use a support with an M8 screw. And it was a good idea because with my knurling turn I arrived at a good result. And then I decided to add two screw holes to the aluminium pulley, but not only, also to the steel wheel. And using my milling machine, the satisfaction for making this hole was great. It was really a funny moment. And really, it was arrived the final assembly. I saw many wheels rolling from left and from right, not only plastic but aluminium and steel too. But also some pins was ready. But how to clean that surfaces? That black oxide, I really didn't like it. I tried by hand, but yeah, was not the solution. In that moment I remember to have a Makita belt sander, a very good machine that stayed in the angle for many years. And with a little pressure, the Makita made for me a very good work. I was a little surprised to have been make that part in a very accurate mode. Making this support is not so difficult, but you have to take attention to some dimension, in particular the dimension of the pins, the dimension of the pulley, and in particular the dimension between the pulleys, because that dimension is directly connected to the dimension of the commercial belt sander. I calculated the distance between the pulleys in order to leave the belt paper free by 1 cm. But unfortunately, I found the belt paper slightly longer than the declared dimension. Fortunately, I had left the recovery level longer in order to cover a possible error that in fact precisely occurred during the assembly of the sandpaper. The assembly of the slack recovery lever is done in such a way as to tighten the nut in the shortening direction of the sandpaper. A self-locking nut allows you to maintain the position during the work. I was very happy to see the elasticity of the sandpaper, just right for leaning and working. And the moment for the testing on the lathe was arrived. The lathe test showed that a light pressure was enough to get a good job. By turning the kernel disc, it was possible to change the worn part of the cloth for the new one that was ready to be used. Polishing for oxide or twist and bury is not important, because the important thing is that this device works very well for this taper work to be done safely. And so, thanks for watching, see you next time. AB Shop.